Our sponsor for this session is Eagle Pipe, your complete supply chain partner. Please visit their page in our sponsor showcase tab.
Tight oil producers face a myriad of challenges, from attracting investment to volatile prices. Providing insight on what the future holds is Benjamin Shattuck, Research Director for America's Upstream Oil and Gas at Wood Mackenzie. Welcome, Ben. Take it away.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I want to thank Hart for inviting me to the Executive Oil Conference. Back in the days of in-person events, EOC was always my favorite. It was the most intimate, most insightful and revealing, and also a fantastic opportunity to sort of rub shoulders in Midland itself. Hopefully next year, we're all back together, able to do this again. My name is Ben Shattuck. I'm a research director here at Wood Mackenzie, and I brought with me today a presentation titled, Will Tight Oil Ever Grow Again? If you're sitting at your screen thinking to yourself, wow, this guy's just lobbing himself a softball, I would urge you not to make the same mistake that I have made and assume that there is consensus around this topic. Each week, I send an email out to our clients around the globe. And recently, I outlined our most updated view on crude oil production, expecting that it was sort of a consensus, very easy email to digest. I've never had more feedback. So when we think about the question, will tight oil ever grow again? Some hear it as, will we ever actually grow again? Or are we in terminal decline? There are those who think that oil production never grows again onshore from today point forward. Others interpret it as, are we going back to 1 million barrels a day of growth the same way that we saw last decade? Still others wonder if we surpass the previous peak of tight oil production in March of this year. And there are views, and you will, if you've paid any attention at all, you have seen each of those views represented over the last month or so with participants and observers of the industry. So what I aim to do today is I'm going to share with you our latest view, and then I'm going to attempt to do what has made more analysts wrong than anything else, and that is to explain why this time around is different. So we'll take all the drama out of it, and we'll start with our updated view on lower 48 crude production. To answer the basic question, we absolutely think that tight oil gets back to growth. However, we think that it's going to take a couple of years of decline. And during that time, a lot of the industry needs to right size and repair its balance sheet. And we'll have a look at that in a moment, in order to enable themselves to be in a position to grow again if prices rise. This is a very price-dependent forecast. And when we get back to growth, we don't, even under the most bullish scenarios, envision a situation where we're growing by 1 million barrels a day in a year again. In fact, we grow by just a little over 1 million barrels a day over the next decade. So we're talking low single digit compounded annual growth rates over the next decade. But certainly we do not expect or forecast decline into the future. So why is it different this time? We of course saw a downturn in 2015. 2016 crude production took off again. We saw consecutive years of 1 million barrels a day.